Welcome to the Yin series. I'm Lucy from the studio, and I'm here to bring you 7 short yin videos, each designed around the energy centers known as the chakras, which are aligned along our spine. So as always with a yin practice, it is best to practice in the evening when you're home from work and can simply unwind and relax. Please get any support that you may need for your practice this evening. This can include bolsters, yoga blocks, bricks, belts, even blankets. So our first posture this evening is actually going to be a pranayama posture that we're going to do standing. So when you're ready, come and stand yourselves up. Now I will get decapitated here, but you'll still be able to see what my hands are doing. So I'm going to stand with the feet at hip distance and just soften through the knees. So we're not overextending, we're not over-engaging, and we're allowing the body to relax as much as it can in a standing posture. You're then going to place your hands just in front of your navel as if you were holding a small pot. One palm faces upwards and the other downwards. And then we're going to breathe very slow and very long. And just start to notice how the navel and the lower back, how those areas start to expand on the in-breath. And then release back towards the spine on the in-breath. And as you breathe deeply, it's very natural that your mind may wander. If you find that happening, just simply notice whatever it was that hooked your attention away, and just softly bring the focus back to rest on the breath. And just see how it feels to breathe deeply, maybe even now closing your eyes, and you'll feel your feet really connect with the mat, keeping the breath nice and soft and long and deep. If you're new to yoga, especially yin yoga, you may well find it easier to just breathe with the eyes open. But remember to just be mindful and be conscious about the qualities of each breath that you take, allowing the breath to just flow effortlessly, one long breath following another. Thank you. And very, very slowly, just start to lower the chin to the chest. Open your eyes. Allow the light to re-enter. Release the hands and lift your gaze. And then we're going to come and lie down on our tummies. Making our way into superior pose. So lying on our tummies in this prostrated position and then bringing the hands into reverse prayer at the back of the neck. And you allow the elbows to connect with the floor, lowering the forehead down to the floor. If you practice yoga more frequently and you wish to work just a little bit more intensely, this posture, superior pose, is a very restorative pose naturally. But if you want to intensify it slightly, you can just bring those blocks down at shoulder distance, bring the elbows onto the blocks, lowering the head in between the arms. And as you lie here in your superior pose, just see if you can feel the pulse and the beat in your abdomen. And just coordinate the movements of the pose with natural and rhythmic breathing. And to ensure the breath is just as deep, be very mindful to breathe into the back of your ribcage. Take a big deep breath in, and then as you exhale, just allow yourself to sigh the air into the mat, melting the heart and the front of the abdomen down into the mat a little more. One more big deep breath in, and exhale. As you inhale, softly lift your head and your chest, bring your arms off any blocks if they're on them. And then we're simply going to push ourselves back and just come to a kneeling position. And just maybe start to roll the shoulders back a little here. And then let's just take a very simple shoulder extension, stretch out in front of us. So we're going to bring the hands into prayer. Inhale, take the arms up. And as you exhale, we'll join the arms right back behind the ears. Inhale, interlock all fingers, turn palms of hands away from body. Draw the arms even further back, but be mindful not to lift the shoulders to the ears. Keep the shoulders down and draw the arms back. Feel that lift, that space, and that expansion across your heart. And very softly, let's come and lie down on our backs. You may wish to lower down, engaging the core by squeezing the navel in and lowering down vertebrae by vertebrae. We're going to come into half happy baby. So we're going to bring both soles of feet together, but we're going to keep the heels a good thigh length away from the pelvis. Then I'm going to ask you to relax this left leg, and we're going to draw the right leg in towards the chest. And then we're going to take it wider than the ribcage, so out to the side, out to the right, and draw that knee down towards the armpit. You can rest your left hand on the inside of your left thigh. Make sure you're relaxing the back of the neck by gently tucking the chin slightly backwards. And then if you can, you're going to flex that right foot and then see if you can stack the right ankle above the left, above the right one. We're going to flex through the right foot. Take hold of the little toe, edge of the foot. And that just allows us to keep the ankle stacked above the knees. And allow the sacrum to just release down onto the legs. Feel your back relaxing and letting go. Feel the space across the right bottom, looking into the right hamstring. You might even feel the attachment points of those three hamstrings into the gluteus muscles. And just see whatever sensations you are experiencing. You may not be experiencing the stretch, you may be feeling some pinching on the inner, so on the inside of the front of the right thigh and right hips into the groin area where your hip flexors are. And they're currently the muscles working to flex the hip joint. And with the exhale, you're encouraging that right knee down towards the mat. As always, your yin breathing, long, slow, deep breaths with even longer, slower out breaths, and that engages our body's natural relaxation response, so the muscles really do lengthen, release, and let go. Take a big deep breath in, and as you exhale, softly encourage that right knee down towards your mat. Then we're gently going to bring the that right leg back in, gently does it, and allow that right leg to rejoin the left one, and then just bring the knees together, draw the heels in, and just take a couple of supinal twists to each side. So as you do a supinal twist, you lower the knees to one side and gaze over the opposite shoulder, and then work the opposite way, making sure you keep both shoulder blades grounded at all times. So you're going to bring the soles of the feet back together. I'm just going to come and lie the other way around on the mat. Just so you can see the left leg lift up. And again, where we bring it, so we bring it wider than the ribcage. Remember, we want to be aiming that left knee down towards our left armpit. We draw the knee in to begin with. And then if you can, you step the left ankle on top of the left knee. Remember, we flex the foot to always protect the bent knee joint, holding onto the little toe edge of the foot, and allowing the right arm to rest down on the right thigh. And just visualize drawing that hip bone in as we draw the knee down. So with this posture, to give you an indication, Ashtanga Yogi, so Ashtanga is a very strong Vinyasa practice. It consists of six series, which are the same flow of postures put together. And this posture, Ananda Balasana, Happy Baby, is in there. This is obviously the half version. And to give you an indication, when Ashtanga Yogis do this posture, their knees are down on the floor. So that's how much you really can open up your hips. Obviously, yin yoga is the opposite end to Ashtanga. But what it does tell us is that with repetition and with practice, the body will relax. The body will simply surrender to the practice. As you exhale, drawing that left knee down towards the mat and towards the armpits as much as you can. And gently bringing the left foot back, gently and slowly to join the right one. And then once again, bring the knees together. Keep the feet at hip distance, arms at shoulder height, as we lower the knees from one side and then the other. Remember to keep both shoulder blades grounded. And then draw the knees in, give yourself a big, big hug. Wrap your arms around your knees and gently rock forwards, backwards, forwards, backwards, until we come up to seated. So for the next one, caterpillar, this is our seated forward fold. You may need to use your bolster here if you find you're very tight in your lower back and hamstrings, in which case you can bring the bolster here and simply just bring your elbows in. Alternatively, you can use a belt around the feet. Just be careful with that, that you don't overextend and reach forwards and therefore compromise the alignment of the spine. At all times when we're working into the lower back, we have to keep the chest open. Or if you can, touch your toes, you can obviously bring the hands down and gently lower the head down. For those of you that are very flexible, you could bring a block behind the soles of the feet. Again, make sure you're not overextending through the arms so the spinal alignment isn't compromised. And we can soften down with each breath. So as we were saying, we are working and focusing on cleansing our Manipura chakra, that's the solar plexus. And that one represents the city of jewels, with an energetic intention to help us step into our personal power, giving us a sense of self-worth, self-esteem, and self-confidence. So whilst we place a lot of focus on the relationships we have with others, the relationship that we have with ourselves is in fact the most important one. And it's this chakra that's all about the relationship with our true self. Also helps us with commitment to stay in difficult situations and find a way through. So it really does help to boost our inner strength. So of course, when this chakra is blocked and when it's out of balance, we're going to have very low self-confidence levels, meaning we lack self-love. However, when it's in balance, it helps us truly transform from the trajectory of our life, helping us feel confident, have high self-esteem, and take better care of ourselves, aligning with our true inner power. So as you find stillness in this posture and caterpillar pose, allow yourself to reflect on your day and your week so far. Don't get lost in thought. Instead, reflect on everything you've achieved, everything you've learned, everything that's been a blessing, even if it's been a blessing in disguise. Starts to happen, we can simply just place a block under the knees or even a rolled up blanket, and that just helps to release the pull on the attachment and insertion points for the hamstrings and gastrocnemius calf muscle. So for the next one, Chakra take a big deep breath in, lengthen all the way from coccyx to crown of head. And as you exhale, squeeze your navel in and fold as far as you can. And again, big breath in. And exhale. And then we're going to hold it here, that bit further into the posture. And just feel how, as the posture's progressing, different states of mind may arise. There may be some states of mind that you want to escape, or there may be physical discomfort arising from the posture. So just use this now, these final few moments in this pose, as an opportunity to get committed to your practice, regardless of the mental and physical circumstances that arise. Taking one more deep breath in, and exhale. Well done. Then as you inhale, let's slowly come up. Go slow, you've been in that for quite some time. Hands down by the hips, fingers point towards the toes, draw the knees in, again at hip distance, and just lower those knees from one side, and then the other. And then we looked at cool twist before when we were laid down on our backs. We're now going to look at it as a true posture. So we're going to lie back down on our mats, drawing the heels in, spreading the arms wide, and then just allowing the knees to hover over to the right side. But hover them just above the mat. If you want to challenge yourself more, you could lift the feet off the mat and lower, and that way you're holding the legs with the core. Now please make sure both shoulder blades remain grounded, as with the previous version of this. It's more yin, it's more restorative to have the toes down on the mat and just allow the legs to hover above. And then gently use your core to inhale, bring those legs back to center. And then exhale, take them to the opposite side. And again, use the core to either hover the knees or the feet and the knees above the mat. Both shoulder blades remain grounded. Breathing into the myofascial lines of tension that run across our spine. If any feel tight, just allowing that tension to be released on your exhalation. Inhale, bring the legs back to center. And again, as we exhale, lower knees to left as we gaze to over right shoulder. This time, you may want to pick your left foot up to the bottom foot and bring it on top of the top knee. That just helps to gently adjust the knee more down and more closer to the mat. Thank you. and softly bring that bottom left foot down. Bring the legs back to center. And as we exhale, take the legs over to the opposite side. Bottom right foot lifts on top of the left knee. Embracing any clicks and cracks that you may detect along your spine. Inviting in some self-compassion and self-love for everything and the children that you have interacted with. That space that you've created in your physical body, as well as that stillness that's been created. As you exhale, encourage that knee down towards the floor. And release that foot gently, bring the legs back to center. And then just extend the legs along the mat to take the arms above the head into multiple fingers, so the palms of hands away from the toes. And as you exhale, bring the arms back down by the hips. Walk the shoulder blades down the spine, palms face upwards, as we bring ourselves into Shavasana. Allowing the back of the body to melt down into the mat. Feeling your breath naturally slow and deepen. Observing the qualities of the breath, the pace, the duration, the texture, even the temperature of each breath in and each breath out. As you relax into your Shavasana, maybe bring this mantra into your head. I am loved, I am happy, and I am at peace. Starting to gently bring movement back to fingers and toes. starting to softly circle wrists and ankles clockwise, then anti-clockwise. Then extending the arms above the head, interlock all fingers, turn palms of hands away from body and foot toes. And as you exhale, draw the knees in towards the chest, wrap your arms around them, and give yourself a big, big hug. And then just gently roll onto the left-hand side. As for one last time this evening, we commit ourselves back to the safety of the earth. And then when you're ready, coming and joining me, back in a seated position with hands in prayer. So thank you for joining me for this evening's yin practice around the Manipura chakra, that's the solar plexus chakra. So that was actually our final chakra of matter. So they're the lower three chakras that are very physical in nature. The fourth video will therefore be on the one that connects the lower three chakras of matter with the top three chakras of spirit. And the one that's the connector is the heart chakra, the Anahata chakra, where we cultivate love and compassion. So I'll see you back on the mat for that practice. Please continue to stay safe and stay well, and I will see you all very soon. Namaste.